Greetings, Saints, Prophetess Dawn O'Brien, servant of the Lord with Dawn's Heartfelt Corner here. I have a word that I want to share with you. You know, I wasn't planning on giving a word, but then the Holy Spirit dropped something in my spirit, and I want to speak it to you. I felt like Paul Begley, you know, because I was listening to him this morning. He's always saying, calm down, you know, go get some coffee, you know, and coffee is the wrong thing to drink. I just want to let you know, unless it's decaf, you know, I only have one cup a day, but I mean, it'll just make you hyper, you know, and so we just need to calm down. There is a lot that's going on. I want to make sure we're online this morning. Yes, I think we're online. You know, there's a lot we need to talk about that I feel God wants us to talk about. You know, I was planning on going up the street, taking my bike up there, but I'm not going to go right now. You know, you never know what God's going to do. You have to be ready in season and out of season. Let's pray and invite the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, you're welcome here to say what you're wanting me to say. This is the day you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, Lord. Help us to be at peace and calm down, not be stressed out, Lord, but to focus our attention upon you, Lord. There is so much happening right now, and that is getting ready to take place, Lord. But we're not going to be afraid, and we're not going to worry, Lord. Our hope and our trust is in you, Lord. We take one day at a time, Lord. Thank you for this day, Lord. We come against all distractions right now, Lord. I ask that your word will go forth, touching hearts and touching lives, and that your anointing will be on the words that I speak, Lord, and that many souls will come to Christ, Lord, that they would come on this website and hear the word of the Lord and give their heart and lives to you, Lord, because it's all about you, Jesus. We want to give you the praise, the honor, and glory in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. You know, I was praying this morning, you know, I'm getting better, Saints. You know, I have the windows open, you know, and they started, you know, out there this morning, you know, and that first thing I get, you know, I slam the window, you know, I still get upset. I take God seriously, you know. So I went outside, and that was nice, you know, and I spoke to the people upstairs, were guys talking loud by my window as usual, and I asked them, do you know what today is, you know, and no, and then I had to tell them what day was, you know, and then, you know, I had to talk to them about the vacuum because they like to run the vacuum at 10, 11, 12. In fact, one night they ran at 1:30 and I was sleeping. And Daniel's like, I'm surprised you didn't wake up. You know, well, God is awesome. Thank you, Jesus, for not waking me up and letting me sleep. You know, because I don't sleep good, for those that don't know. In 2000, I was in a very dangerous car accident. Brain surgery on the right side of my brain. You can go to our website, www.dawnsheartfeltcorner.org. You can read my whole testimony. For those that hear me talk and they hear me slur my speech, I was in a dangerous car accident. I should have been dead. I'm a walking miracle. I'm here for a reason, and so are you. We're here to testify about the Lord Jesus Christ. And I believe God is wanting to save people. These are the last days. You know, and so when people look at me, they're going to say, wow, you're a walking miracle. And Jesus gets the praise, the honor, and glory. What a mighty God we serve. You know, today is Good Friday. And I want to read you this. I'm getting ready to put this up on Facebook. And remember what Jesus did for you and I on the cross. Let's remember what Christ did. What pain and agony God went through for us. What a loving and merciful Savior, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Christ would have died if it was only for you. That's right. Christ would have died just for you. Maybe you don't know Christ yet. I want you to know he loves you. Give your heart and life to him now. Don't wait. You know, God is trying to reach people. They see everything that's going on. We don't need to worry or be afraid. You know, God is in control. You know, he promised to protect us and keep us safe. You know, if you're in God's will and you know Jesus, you don't have to worry. You know, for people that don't know Christ, they have a reason to worry. You know, if you've never given your heart and life, just go to him and say, Jesus, forgive me of my sins. Wash me and cleanse me in your blood. I want to know you. Just say that prayer. Sincerely, the prayer is up on the screen. You can pray to receive Christ, but do it now. He loves you. I want to read you the scripture, Matthew 27:45-54. Jesus dies on the cross. Now from the sixth hour until the ninth hour, there was darkness over all the land. Verse 46. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, that is, my God, why have you forsaken me? Verse 47, some of those who stood there when they heard that said, this man is calling for Elijah. Verse 48, immediately one of them ran and took a sponge, filled it with sour wine, and put it on a reed and offered it to him to drink. Verse 49, the rest said, let him alone. Let us see if Elijah will come to save him. And Jesus cried out again with a loud voice and yielded up his spirit. Verse 51, then behold, the veil of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom, and the earth quaked, and the rocks were split. Verse 52, and the graves were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. Verse 53, and coming out of the graves after his resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many. So in the centurion, well, this was after. I'm reading this. This is after Jesus rose. I'm reading this, and this goes along with the Easter weekend, where if I may do a video on Resurrected Sunday, but I placed up a video for Good Friday. But let me finish reading this, because this was after Jesus arose. And coming out of the graves after his resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many. So when the centurion and those with him who were guarding Jesus saw the earthquake and things that happened, they feared greatly, saying, truly, this was the Son of God. You know, I placed that up there. I was going to put a Good Friday scripture, but this is okay because I have my title on there, How Blessed and Safe Good Friday and Resurrected Sunday. And I placed that scripture. I'm doing so much things. I really am. The Holy Spirit has me doing things continually. And I put it under here, and I want to read this to you. When I think of all Christ went through on the cross during the cold winter months and my asthma acts up, God reminds me what he went through on the cross. It was extremely hard for him to breathe. He had to lift up his chest to get air in his lungs. Anyone that has asthma knows what I'm talking about. If you have asthma, you know what I'm talking about. My asthma has actually been really good right now. You know, it's cool here in Florida. It's not been, well, it's warming up, I should say. We didn't have a cold winter, so I thank God. You know, I still take my asthma medication. I take an inhaler, and I have to take my nebulizer. I usually only take it once a day, and I usually take it at night. Something about the evilness in the air, I don't know. It just seems to bother me at night. But pray for me. I pray for you, too, that God will heal us. You know, God is in control. You know, I'm trying to eat better, too, you know, because I told you, maybe for you it's different, but for me, I have asthma. It could be different things. It could be allergies. It could be animals, dander, cat dander. I'm allergic to cats and foods. If I have too much dairy foods, it affects my asthma. All right, let me finish reading this. Anyone that has asthma knows what I'm talking about. It's hard to breathe, and you have to breathe even harder, lifting up your chest to get air. What you and I go through in our suffering and trials are nothing compared to all that Christ has gone through to save you and me. What a mighty God we serve, praise Jesus. Today and every day of our lives, let us offer a praise and thanksgiving to Jesus Christ for giving us salvation and life forevermore. God bless you and your families. Daniel, I pray you have a blessed, safe Good Friday and Resurrection Sunday. And we do. And if I have time, you know, the same one that made that video, which I pray I don't get a strike, they said you can use it. So the same one that I put the Good Friday up, I might put the Resurrected Sunday. But let's have a little worship here first before we get started. And then I want to share an important word with you. We're going to worship this morning. Let's all to Jesus I surrender.
Oh, Jesus, I surrender. Lord, I give myself to Thee. Fill me with Thy love and power. Let Thy blessing
Amazing grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but
now I see. Thank you, Lord.
I see.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. They love to worship Jesus. I love him. Let's sing this one. My hope is built on nothing less. These old hymns, I love them.
Is built on nothing less than Jesus' love and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest friend, but only lean on Jesus' name.
Sing it, sing.
On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus. Darkness lies his loving face. I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds.
Yes, it does.
In the bed of on Christ the solid rock I stand. All other
every hour. We need you, Jesus. We need you every hour, Lord.
In every hour of the day.
Yes.
In every hour of the night. Oh, Lord, I need you. I'm desperate for you, Lord. I'm desperate for more of you,
I need thee every hour.
Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus. This is all. Remember this? I love this.
Trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word, just to rest upon His promise, just to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how proved you more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. I'm so glad I learned to trust Him. Precious Jesus, Savior, friend. And I know that He is with me, will be with me to
the end. Yes, He'll be with us till the end. Praise you, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him. How I proved you more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Jesus, how I trust Him, how I've proved Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more.
Lord, we trust You, Father. We trust You, Lord. We trust You, Lord.
I'm so glad I learned to trust Him. Precious Jesus, Savior, friend. And I know that
us.
He is with me. Will be with me to
the end.
Jesus, Jesus. How I trust Him, how I proved Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I proved Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. For grace to trust Him
more. We love You, Jesus. We love You. We worship You, Lord. We exalt You. Hallelujah. He's here. Saints, He's here this morning. I love to worship Jesus. I love the Lord. God is so good. He loves you. You know, we can trust Jesus no matter what is happening in our world today. We can trust Jesus. We can't look to man, but we can trust the Lord. God is there and He's with us. He says in His word, He'll never leave us nor forsake us. God is good, saints. God is good. He's good all the time. No matter what we're going through, good times and bad times, God is good. God is good. You know, He allows this. All these things that we go through to humble us so that we seek Him. And, you know, He's coming back for a bride without spot or wrinkle. We don't know when He's coming, you know, but we have to be ready. You know, He'll come when we least expect it. But I want to share a word with you. I'm very sensitive, you know that. So the Holy Spirit, I cry a lot. I lost where I was reading. I was going to read your scripture here. It's important that we be built on the solid rock, Christ Jesus, not on sinking sand. And our churches, you know, your pastors, you need to be built on the rock, Christ Jesus, because the storm is coming. The storm is coming. Let me find that word. I lost it. Matthew, I believe it's in chapter 7. Matthew 7, starting verse 24. The wise and foolish builders. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. We need to be built on the rock, Christ Jesus. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, yet it did not fall because it had its foundation on the rock. Verse 26, but everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, verse 27,
the streams rose. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash. Verse 28, when Jesus had finished saying these things, okay, wait a minute, let's stop right there. You know, so it's important that we build on the rock, Christ Jesus, because if we're not, it's going to crash, saints. So it's important that we build our churches on the rock, and that goes for the pastors. It's important we get back to the Word of God and preach the true gospel, because when the storm comes, if we're not built on Christ, anything else but Christ, it's gonna fall. Now, let me share some encouraging words with you, and then we're gonna get into some news, and I'm gonna share the word with you today. But this word is, you know, from that grace for today, that little 1 minute devotion. I'm gonna read it, and I like this. Today's the 14th. Tomorrow's the 15th. Prayer is essential. Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went off to a solitary place where he prayed. That's Mark 1:35. Some of God's children are just too busy, and that's right. We're seeing that. They're busy going here, going there. They're just too busy. We're becoming like the world. We need to get away and spend time with our Father. Even if you are extremely busy in the service of the Lord but are not supported by the power of faithful prayer, while you work, you run the risk of a complete breakdown and burnout of your spiritual life. You know, you can be a pastor and a leader, and you can be doing things and that, but, you know, it's not the same as spending quality time with your Father. It's so important that you're getting refreshed, and that goes for me as well. You know, I don't want to be so where I'm doing everything. I want to be doing what God's called me to do. You know, I'm not there yet, so pray for me, you know, because I know I'm going to get very busy, and, you know, I have to set time for this and for that and do what's important instead of doing things that are not important, because the time is speeding up, saints, and we're seeing that. We're running out of time, so it's important that we do those things that God is asking us to do and quit wasting time and doing things that he's not asking us to do. Because those things, I'm going to tell you right now, when we get to heaven, we're not going to be rewarded for those things that are not led by the Spirit of the Lord. If we're just doing vain things, and he never led us to do those things, we're not going to be rewarded. We're only rewarded for what is of the Lord. All right. Let me finish reading this to you. All right. Even if you're extremely busy in the service of the Lord, but are not supported by the power of faithful prayer while you work, you run the risk of a complete breakdown, burn of your spiritual life. You cannot fulfill your spiritual duty without prayer. It's so important, saints. There's no vacation for the Christian. Prayer is the encouragement and inspiration for Christian service. It gives sincerity to everything that you embark on in the Master's name and gives you a deep satisfaction that you cannot get from any other source. And that's so true. You know, I have time right now. I'm home. I have all day. Now, I know I'm not going to have this time. One of these days, yes, I'll still put God first. I never want to not put the Lord first, but I'm not going to have all the time on my hands like I do now. God told me this a while back. He said, enjoy this time because you're going to get very busy, and I'm seeing I'm getting busier, and there's just not enough time in one day to do what I normally do, so we're running out of time. And here's a little prayer. Father, through your favor, may I experience more comfort in times of adversity, more sorrow over sin, more joy in my labors. May I be inspired by prayer and pursue your example diligently. Amen. Well, I want to pray for all of us. Father, I pray for us, Lord, that we would just do whatever it is you're asking us to do. What's important, Lord, that we'll cut off all those things that, Lord, that may be trying to take our attention away from you, Lord, and that we just do the things that you're calling us to do, Lord. That's important, not waste time, Lord. We're living in the last days, and we're seeing that you're speeding up the time, Lord, and you want to use your people, Lord, all of us, Lord. So I pray for all of us, Lord, that we would be obedient, Lord, to listen to your voice, Lord, to hear you speak to our hearts, Lord, and what you're wanting us to do, and that we would do it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All right, let me read, I'm not going to read Prophet Russ's word. I'll read Marsha Burns. I put them up there for you to look at, both of them. But Marsha Burns said this, and I really like the saints, and this is for a word for the body of Christ. I really like this. In a vision, she said, I saw myself looking down into a deep well, and I heard the Lord say, go deep. Many of you, my people, have skimmed the surface of what you consider to be relationship with me. You become complacent and satisfied with the shells of the familiar. I want you to explore the depths. I want you to grow spiritually and go beyond your comfort zone to me better. And that's true. God is getting ready to kick us out of our comfort zones. All right? He's getting ready. Remember, we've talked about it. He's getting ready to discipline the body of Christ. Not to punish us, but he's coming back for a bride without spot or wrinkle, a blameless, holy bride. And it says here, John 4, 11 through 14, the scripture, which I said the other day, actually. I didn't know the scripture, but she talks about it here. She wrote the scripture, John 4, 11 through 14. The woman said to him, "Sir, you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep." It's the woman at the well. Where did you get that living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, she said, who gave us the well and drank from himself as well as his sons and his livestock? Jesus answered and said to her, "Whoever drinks of this water will thirst again. But whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst. But the water that I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up into an everlasting life." You know, when God is going to have himself some people that are going to worship him in spirit and in truth. You know, that Lord gave me that the other day. Let's, before we get into this word here, I want to go over here real quick. And let's go over to, I want to share, you know, Paul Bagley. I put some of his videos because he lets me. I put them up on our website. He's talking about, go listen to China offering North Korea a deal. Give up your nukes and we'll protect you. We're going to talk about that in just a minute. Okay? And then he's saying that North Korea is going to test a nuke despite what Trump is saying. Okay? That's what he's saying. And we're going to read you some of this here. Then we're going to look at these earthquakes, because I'm telling you, California is still getting some big earthquakes here. North Korea, for fears of wars, North Korea to test nuclear weapons despite Trump warning. This came out today. All right. I'm reading this article from Metro UK. The threat of war between the U.S. and North Korea is edging ever closer after Kim Jong-un said he will test nuclear weapons despite Trump warning against it. He's going to do it no matter what, saints. All right. Officials in North Korea today warned that President Donald Trump's troublemaking and aggressive tweets have led to the extremely tense situation on the Korean Peninsula. Now, we need to pray, saints. We need to pray for President Trump. We need to pray for the White House. We need to pray for our enemies. I mean, you know, God bless President Trump. You know, I love him. But I'm telling you right now, he said some things that sound like he was acting very prideful. And I'm going to tell you right now, God showed me this before, and I'm going to read it to you. God needs him to be humble, okay? Because we're living in the last days, and we are going to see some things take place. I'm telling you right now, we're not going home yet. I know people are saying, well, it's Good Friday, and deliverance is coming. Jesus is coming. Where did Jesus say that? Did he tell you he was coming? Just because you're seeing all these things, Jesus said you're going to have wars, rumors of war, pestilence, earthquakes, and a famine. We've talked about that before. Where does it say that we're going to fly out of here? We're automatically leaving, that Jesus is getting out of here. He said this is the beginning of sorrow. Yes, he did say, look up, your redemption draweth nigh. Now, I do believe we're about to get out of here, and that, but remember, to God, one day is like 1,000 years. 1,000 years, I'd like one day to the Lord. There are souls that still need to come to Christ. We're going to see a big revival. We're going to see a falling away. I've talked about that before. And then we're also going to see the man of perdition revealed. There are things in prophecy that still need to be fulfilled. So nowhere did Jesus say we're going to go home. He's not going to tell you to pack your bags, get ready, saints, we're going home. People that say that are living in fear. They're being afraid. No, we're not to be afraid. We're to trust God. He promised to take care of us. All right? He knows exactly what's being played out right now. God knows. He made everything. He made you. He made me. Don't you think God knows? All right? We don't need to worry. What about the birds? Remember we talked about that in Matthew 6? If God took care of the birds there, will he take care of you and I? Paul talked about it. If we have our needs met, food and clothing, not all of our material blessings. Okay, now that's hard to say. I don't know how he said all that. You know, God got him to the point. He called momentary troubles. Now, if he could do it, I pray that I can do it. Lord, help us, Lord, to be more like Paul, the apostle, Lord, the disciples of the Lord. They were able to handle whatever came their way, Lord. And, Lord, you didn't just take them out quickly, Lord. Lord, we have to go through things. We can't just think of a cop-out, Lord. We have to wait on you, Lord. You have a timing, Lord. It's your timing, not our timing, Lord. So, Father, help us to wait, Lord. Help us to be patient and endure, Lord, and to win souls for you and do what you've asked us to do in Jesus' name. You know, I get so angry when I hear people saying, well, we're automatically getting out of here. No, I don't believe that. God has not shown Daniel and I that. God took 20 years to prepare us. So why? I don't believe we're automatically going to, we're leaving. I don't believe that. I've got messages that I've done. All right, I've done a tub full of messages that God has had me prepare. I've done over 500 poems, and Jesus gets the glory. It's not about me, but he's been preparing me, and I'm sure you, for such a time as this. We're getting ready to see a great revival. Remember, he talked about the greater miracles. We haven't done that yet. You know, how can we leave when we haven't done greater things than what Jesus talked about? He said we're going to do them. You know, it may be short, maybe only, what, 3-6 months? I don't know. Only God knows. It's going to be like, remember John the Baptist, prepare ye the way for the Lord. We got to warn people so that they'll get their heart and life right. And there are going to be those that aren't going to listen. All right? They think we're crazy now. They persecute us and say all kinds of things. Oh, well, praise the Lord. We can't let that bother us. We're going to be persecuted. Blessed are you when you're persecuted, for great is your reward. You're going to be persecuted, and so am I. They're not going to like us. They're going to say all kinds of evil. All right? But praise the Lord. We know we're getting out of here. We know where we're going. But the question is, do you know? Do you know where you're going when you die? You know, I get people on here all the time saying stuff about Paul Bagley, Pastor Paul Bagley, saying evil things. And then they say evil things about me. You know, but praise God. We're to love them. All right. Let me go back to this now. I was reading this to you. The article about the North Korea, about how he said he's going to test nuclear weapons despite Trump's warning. He's not listening, all right? And then down here it says, officials in North Korea today warned that President Donald Trump's troublemaking and aggressive tweets have led to the extremely tense situation on the Korean peninsula. North Korean Vice Minister Han Sung Royal said, we will go to war if they choose. After reports emerged that the U.S. is thought to be considering launching a preemptive missile strike. All right. The U.S. sent a Navy strike group towards the Western Pacific in a show of force, which led to North Korea responding with warnings of a nuclear attack in retaliation. China responded to Han's comments with his foreign minister, Wang Yi, saying there would be no winner in any way, and that dialogue is the only possible solution. But North Korea does not seem to be backing down, accusing the U.S. of attacking Syria last week. In a statement, a spokesman for the North Korean Foreign Ministry's Institute for Disarmament and Peace said, the U.S. introduces into the Korean Peninsula the world's biggest hotspot, huge nuclear strategic assets. And we've heard about what President Donald Trump just did. He sent off that mother of bombs just the other day. I mean, what was that about? You know, we come against ISIS, you know, I mean, it's like we're saying nothing can happen to America, that we're going to come after you. You know, we have to be careful, you know, because like I told you, I believe it's going to turn on America. All right. Down here, it says, this has created a dangerous situation in which a thermonuclear war may break out at any moment on the peninsula. Now, remember, I talked about that lady that had a vision dream about a thermal bomb being prepared. We're going to talk about that in a minute. Over the past week, Trump ordered airstrikes on Syrian air base in response to a chemical weapon attack and dropped the mother of all bombs in Afghanistan, killing 36 ISIS fighters. U.S. military planes have also been conducting military drills alongside Japan and the Korean Peninsula. Trump tweeted on Tuesday, North Korea is looking for trouble. If China decides to help, that'd be great. If not, we will solve the problem without them, USA. See, we've gotten so prideful that we're going to solve it ourselves. Well, where is God in all this? Where is God? President Trump, where is God in all this? We're going to solve all this ourselves. No, we're not. We need God's help. All right, alluding to Trump's hints, Han said, As long as the nuclear threats and blackmail go on with the military exercise, we will carry forward with our national defense buildup, the core of which is nuclear arms buildup. All right, that's the first article. All right, I want to talk to you about this now. China offers, this is coming from the dailycaller.com, China offers to defend Kim Jong-un if he gives up on his nuke. Now, what is all this about? Okay, let me, I've got some articles here I want to read you here. China offers to defend Kim Jong-un if he gives up his nukes. China would be willing to offer the North Korean regime protection if it abandoned its nuclear weapons, a well-known Chinese paper reports. North Korea's primary reason for developing nuclear weapons is the preservation of the state and the regime through deterrence, yet the U.S. and its allies refuse to accept a nuclear-armed North Korea. Evidence suggests that North Korea may be preparing for another nuclear test this weekend. This path has no outlet. It doesn't matter if North Korea tests a few more nuclear bombs or a few more missiles. It will not make any difference. The Global Times, an outlet affiliated with the state-run People's Daily, the paper of the ruling Communist Party, wrote Thursday. Washington does not fear North Korea, and another nuclear test increases the likelihood that U.S. will use military force. North Korea's current course is not sustainable in putting the survival of the regime in jeopardy. If North Korea does not end its nuclear activities, this end is inevitable, the newspaper explained, adding that even the U.S. does not attack it, sanctions will eventually cripple the North Korean state. Then it says, Pyongyang may assume that atomic bombs and intercontinental ballistic missiles are the keys to ensuring national political security, but this is wrong. The Global Times argued, further commenting on the international community. China included will not stand idly by while North Korea tests increasingly powerful nuclear weapons. Beijing will not patiently allow Pyongyang to continue its nuclear activity. This is where the U.S. and China are in agreement, the paper noted. The difference is that Beijing insists on a peaceful solution that does not threaten the regime, while Washington may use force and take extreme measures, in a separate article. The outlet reported that President Donald Trump, who recently bombed Syria for crossing the line with chemical weapons, is a man who honors his promises and may take military action against North Korea's nuclear weapons program. Reports suggest that China's People's Liberation Army has been put on alert for a possible contingency on the peninsula as tensions arise. If North Korea complies with China's advice and suspends nuclear activities, China will actively work to protect the security of a denuclearized North Korean nation and regime. The Global Times wrote that China is willing to build a positive future for both sides of the Yalu River. In addition to warning North Korea against continued provocation, China also warned the U.S. against military action. Now, what's that about? Military force cannot resolve the issue, Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi reported. Now, listen to what he just said. In addition to warning North Korea against continued provocation, China also warned the U.S. against using military action. Remember, he said he's going to protect North Korea if they're not going to use their nukes. We're going to talk about this in a minute. All right, something is getting ready to happen. All right, and we're not going to die, saints. We're not going to die. All right, we're going to talk about this in just a minute. Let's look at these earthquakes for just a minute. Let's look at the live earthquake map real quick because I don't want to forget to look at it. Let's look at, and then I'm going to talk to you a little more about this. Okay, we've been having a lot of earthquakes in California, all right? Ones, they're now they're up in the threes. I think there was a big one yesterday. There was a 3.3 and a 3.1 that was over an hour ago, and a 2.0, 1.9 Hawaii. Nevada's been having some earthquakes, too. There was a 4.2 in Argentina, three hours ago, and Puerto Rico, 3.4. There was a 4.5 in Philippines 4 hours ago. 4.7 in Djibouti. I'm not sure where that's at. California had 3.2 5 hours ago, and so did the British Virgin Islands, 3.0. Nevada had a 2.1 in Nevada 5 hours ago, 1.4 in Alaska. There's been some 2.6 and 2.3 6 hours ago in British Virgin Islands. There was a volcano in Alaska, that was a small 1.1. But there was some here last night. Let me see if I can get down. I don't know if it's on this map. There was a 4.3 in Mexico 8 hours ago. Now, I don't know if they degraded these and they took them down, but there was a bunch in Nevada and they had some in California. So we're seeing more earthquakes. Let me see. Let me pull up another map here. Let me write something here. Maybe I can get something else. All right. Yesterday at 6 o'clock, there was a 3.5 earthquake. There was, let's see, today, 3.1 and a 3.2 at 6:38 a.m. There was a 3.1 at 10:14. Last night, they had 2.7 in San Francisco, or Hidden Valley Lake, California, at 3:56 a.m., and 9:31 p.m. there was a 3.0. So we're seeing them now in the threes over there. I thought they had a 4. But USPG is downgrading. They don't want you to know what's happening. All right. Let me go over here now and talk to you about this. Okay. Okay, remember yesterday, I came up here, I did actually two videos. I did a video about, let's see, where is it? Wars. I talked about wars and rumors of wars on a letter of President Donald Trump, which we're going to read again today. All right, I talked about that on the 13th, Daniel and I woke up. Remember, I told you the alarms kept going off. All right, they were working on alarms outside. And I felt God was telling me something's getting ready to happen. All right. Then, just yesterday, was that yesterday? I told you I'm losing track of the days. What is today? The 14th, right? Yeah. I'm trying to think. Yesterday? Okay. I'm losing track. One day, there was a bunch of alarms that went off. It was either the 12th, and then the 13th, there was one alarm that went off. So, I mean, we've been getting, that happened only once, and then it stopped. Now, today, we didn't get no alarm. Now, I believe God wanted me up yesterday, and that's what happened. I believe God's cheer, he gave me that word on the 12th about the wars and rumors of wars, okay? And that's when the alarms started going off. And then, remember, I told you I tried to share the word at about, at nighttime. I think it was like 10 to 11, and it didn't go up. I saw the little red live stream on here, but it did not share the video. I was so upset. I went to bed. I was angry. And then when I got the next day, there was all these alarms going off in our apartment. I mean, the whole alarm system. Well, they were testing them outside, and that was when the Lord was showing me that something's getting ready to take place. So I went ahead and I shared the word about the wars and rumors of wars and letter to President Donald Trump. I wrote that the night before. And I didn't know whether God wanted me to share it or not. But then the next day, that's when the alarm went off. I said, well, I'm going to share it. You know, one alarm went off and I felt that God wanted me to share that word. So I shared it. Then I came back and I did another word. And I'm going to just briefly talk about it for a minute. I shared a word. Where is the anti-submarine that was off California coast? And where is it from? Remember I told you there was a submarine that was on the California coast. Now, was it Russians or North Koreans? Well, I don't know. You know, where did it go? It got there, what, Sunday night? Okay, well, the Lord was showing me this. I feel, that's why I said, you pray about it. I could be wrong. You know, I don't know. I really don't know. I'm just bringing it out there. All right. He showed me this, and it reminded me of a vision that a lady from Chosen Exposure Ministry had. She had a vision about a thermal explosive that she saw this bomb, a homemade bomb being made, like a thermal bomb. And she showed pictures of it, actually. And I was looking at reading what about this website about how Kim Jong-un is getting ready to celebrate his dad's birthday, which is tomorrow, the 15th. And he was preparing to note a nuclear bomb in a tunnel. Okay, now, I was looking up thermobaric weapon, and I placed all the websites up there for you to look at. Well, when I was looking it up, it said the blast wave destroys reinforced buildings and equipment and kills and injures people. The antipersonal effect of the blast wave is more severe in foxholes and tunnels. Well, then the Holy Spirit had me look at those tunnels in California. Now, are they underneath in the ocean? Could our enemy put something in a tunnel? I don't know. You pray about it. That's what came to me. I was like, wow. You know, so I'm just sharing with you. Pray about it and see what God is saying to you. So they said they're getting ready to celebrate this thing for his father. You know, and they were sitting on the California coast. Well, what were they doing there? And have they left? You know. So I did that video. Go and take a look at it. I just did that yesterday. And remember, I did a prophetic word about on November 2015. I heard at 2:30 in the morning, I heard God say something to me about an EMP attack is headed our way. Okay? That was back in 2015. And she gave that vision about the thermo bomb in 2015, February. And that was true. That was like a confirmation. Now, when I gave that word that it was headed our way, okay, let me go back. And so, now, I want you to pray about this, because I don't know. I really don't know, Saints. That's what came to me back in 2015. The Lord gave me that, and Chosen Explosion got that bomb. Now, I don't know. Could they be putting something in the water? I don't know. Only God knows. Now, I want to share what I felt God shared with me today. Now, I was not planning on doing a word. I just didn't want to do one, you know. I get tired of saints, you know. I've been on doing words. But, you know, we have to be ready in season. Honestly, we never know what God's doing. And I believe we can no longer plan our own life and what we want to do. It's got to be God. Do what God wants us to do. Our lives are committed to God. When we've surrendered and given God our life, it's his. And I believe if God wants to do something soon, we have to be ready. So this is what he was saying to me, and I'm just going to share it with you, okay? And remember, if we don't share it, God is going to hold us accountable. Prophetic servants, if we know something and we don't say it, the blood will be on our hands. So I'm getting this word out there. I want you to pray about it. I want you to ask the Lord, what is he saying to your spirit? But, I mean, this just came to me, all right? I mean, I normally don't give, like when I said to California, if God's telling you to get out, you need to get out. I don't normally give words like that, but I'm seeing God change me more. And so pray for me, saints, because this is, you know, this is all new for me. I believe the Holy Spirit is speaking to me in different things. He's getting me prepared to speak and this prophetic gift. So pray for me, saints, that I will hear God more clearly. But Amos 3:7-8 says, when the Lord God decides to do something, he will first tell his servants the prophets. When a lion roars, people are frightened. When the Lord God speaks, a prophet must prophesy. Now, at 27, I heard God say this, and I'm just going to say it. All right? And then we're going to read it. I said, President Trump, do not trust China. I hear the Lord say that. I heard him say that out of nowhere. President Trump, do not trust China. I heard him say this. Now I'm talking to the president. We're going to read that word. This is what God put on my spirit. This was at 9:27 a.m. I keep hearing the Holy Spirit say, do not trust China. China is allies with North Korea, and they sent 150,000 troops to their border. Now, I put up the article about China deploys troops to North Korea border. You can read the article. And I got a video by Israel, I forget, some Israel something. China moves huge military column to the border, and then a breaking live a Chinese video. I forget he said what he said. I put the link up there for you to look at. But I also put up another link about China offers North Korea a deal, which was done by Paul Bagley. He heard that. All right. This war that is getting ready to take place will cripple America. And I said that the other day. What was that word I gave just the other day? I heard the Holy Spirit say that to me again today. I just gave a word, I believe. Let's see what it is. I don't even remember. I'm telling you, saying God's always giving me something. I just had a word. Where is it? America shall be crippled for life. That was a word he just gave me. Go listen to it on 4-8, okay? Let's get back over here. Alright, so he gave me that word on the 8th. This war that is getting ready to take place will cripple America. I sense the Lord saying to my spirit, we have not asked God what we are to do. We have not even asked God. We don't go to God no more. We're doing it on our own. We are moving forward on our own, and God is not with us. Alright? I'm just going to tell you, God is not with us. We're making all these decisions on our own. Remember the prophets long ago that God used to speak to the kings whether they should go to war or not? Do you remember that in the Old Testament? If the prophets told them to go to war, they went to war. If not, they weren't to go, but there was times that they went, and what happened? Israel got crushed. You know, prophets Don O'Brien, I'm just going to say it, prophets Don O'Brien is telling you, Mr. President, do not start a war. Do not start a war. The Lord is telling me that. No one will be on your side. Do not trust China. China is not your ally. China is your enemy. I'm going to tell you right now. China is your enemy. And I felt that. The Lord is telling me, don't trust China. He told me something else here. And I'm going to read you this prayer. Father God, I pray for President Donald Trump. Let's pray and agree. We pray for President Donald Trump that you would give him ears to hear from your spirit and not be led by his flesh. Dear Lord, I pray right now for America. Keep America safe from its enemies. We cannot trust no one. Do you hear me? We can't trust no one. Dear Lord, you're the only one we can trust. Father God, keep Israel, the apple of your eye, protected in Jesus' name. Then we have Russia on the other end and Syria. We can't trust them neither. Russia is backing Assad. Thank you for your angels that are watching over us and protecting us. We love you, Lord Jesus, and we stay close to your side in Jesus' name. I'm telling you right now, something's coming insane. And this was the scripture God gave me, and I'm going to read it to you. Psalm 91, safety of abiding in the presence of God. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God in Him will I trust. Verse 3, surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. Verse 4, He shall cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day. Verse 6, nor the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor the destruction that lays waste at new day. 7, 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. Verse 9, because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. Verse 11, for he shall give his angels charge over you, to keep you in all your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Verse 13, you shall tread upon the lion and the cobra. The young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot. Because he set his love upon me, verse 14, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him high on him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. That's right, God is there. Just call upon him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Verse 16, with long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. God is there, saints. We don't need to fear. If you know Christ, you do not need to be afraid. All right, it's not the end yet. We're not going home yet. God is in control. God is in control. All right, we're going to pray before we leave again. We're going to pray. We're going to keep praying. You need to pray. It's important, saints, that we pray for one another. Pray for our nation. Pray for our president. Pray for our, the enemies that are, you know, God is in control. It's important we pray. I want to read this poem, America Will Fall This Day. And I wrote this. It's kind of like a prophecy. Back in 2016, I read this to you before. America will fall this day. America once looked to God and prayed. You have walked away. I declare to you, America will fall or what may. America, America, no longer is God your head. God's nowhere around. We don't seek the Lord. You have become a harlot making your own bed. How far have you gone turning your back? Make no doubt, God is not slack. The beginning of tribulation is now, says the Lord. Judgment for America is here. Saints of God, don't fear. Stay close to God. He is very near. If you do not know Christ, your time is now, says the Lord. Do not wait. That's right. Do not wait. The prayer is up on the screen. Call upon the Lord today and be saved. America is filled with horror and hate. Say, Jesus, say this prayer. Just say it. If you have not said it, say, Jesus, I need you to save me from hell this very day. Wash me and cleanse me. Blot all my sins away. I receive you in my heart this day. Thank you for your love poured out to me in a special way. Noah gave a strict warning that the flood was coming. No one wanted to listen until it came. The flood came and it did not look the same. That is what will happen to America. Now it's not going to be a flood. It's going to be something else. America will not look the same. This is what will happen to America. Receive this word today, says the Lord. America will never be the same. A disaster will hit our nation. This is no game. Hallelujah. This is no game. We need to wake up. Be wise, says the Lord. It's time we get wise. It's time we wake up. All right? Listen and heed to God's warning. America is closer than it's ever been. There is a war that is coming, says the Lord. And I believe this was a prophetic word God gave. There is a war that is coming, says the Lord. America, you will lose and not win. You will lose and not win. Do not go to war. President Donald Trump, do not trust China. All right? Do not start a war. God is not with you. They have many more compared to your few. In the Old Testament, God was not with Israel. They lost the war. You are blinded, says the Lord. America is prideful to the very core. Now America will be humble for all to see. This nation has become a disgrace. God help thee. Where else can the people turn? There is nowhere, saints. We better turn to Jesus. Turn to Jesus or else burn. Everyone who calls on the name of Christ today will be saved. You have to call on Christ. I'm telling you right now, don't wait. Don't keep putting it off for a later date. We don't have much more time. I told you before, I believe there's going to be people in their death that say, God, save me. Jesus, save me. You know, it's going to happen, saints. I'm telling you, something huge is going to take place. And many are going to lose their lives. You know, remember I told you, the government is preparing their bodies, caskets. And they got, they're setting up these, what do you call those camps everywhere? What's that for? They're preparing for something. They know something. They're not telling you, okay? With all these asteroids or meteors flying by, all these earthquakes now happening. Okay, I believe we're going to see a lot of things. We don't need to worry. I know people, you get worried. We don't need to be worried. We need to stay calm. We need to get built in Christ. So we need to get the Word of God in us. You won't be worried. If you know the Lord and you're grounded in the Lord, you're going to stand on God's Word. And then what's going to happen? We're going to mount up on wings like the eagles and we're going to soar. The greater one lives in us, saints. If you've got Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the greater one lives in you. He's in you. You've got all power in you. Jesus is in you. All right? He's getting ready to use a lot of us that are willing to do his will. Remember what he said, the harvest play with the workers are few. God wants to use you. Quit worrying about everything else. Start doing what God is asking you to. If you haven't been doing a prodigal son or daughter, you need to start doing it. All right? You need to start doing what God is asking you to do. All right. I'm going to share this word. I read it the other day. This was a word concerning President Donald Trump, a mighty army of arm bearers rising up in the land. This was from Veronica West. I got this on my Facebook. Early hours of this morning, I was awoken suddenly, they said, with these words echoing in my spirit. Now the spirit of the Lord had turned away from Saul, and an evil spirit from the Lord tormented him. 1 Samuel 16:14. Immediately I sat up and I began to inquire of the Lord. As I prayed, the Holy Spirit again quickened his word to me. Then he instructed me to begin to pray and intercede for President Donald Trump and the nation of America in this hour. As I began to cry out to the Lord, the Holy Spirit likened President Donald Trump to me as King Saul in the Bible. Now this came as a surprise to me. Then I was led to pray very strategically that President Donald Trump would not fall prey to the same traps set by the enemy as King Saul did while he was appointed as King of Israel. The Holy Spirit led me to pray that President Donald Trump would always obey God's word and follow God's leading for the nation. I prayed that the sin of disobedience and the sin of pride would be far from Donald Trump's heart, and indeed from the hearts of those that are serving in his administration. I cried out to God that he would protect Donald Trump from becoming impulsive and unwise in his decisions for the nation. I sought the heart of God for mercy and President Trump, his administration, and for the people in the land. I asked God to raise up those who would stand faithfully in the gap for this newly appointed King of America. As I stayed in the place of intercession, suddenly I was shown in the spirit a mighty army rising up in the nation of America. And then I heard these words, and the David anointing will bring peace to the heart of the king, and he will lead the nation with divine wisdom, counsel, revelation, and understanding, and great prosperity and restoration shall come to the land. After hearing these words, I pressed in deeper, listening, waiting, and watching intently. Then again I was shown in the spirit room a mighty army rising up in great power and authority in the land. I saw bold, faith-filled men, women, and even little children who God has prepared for such a time as this. The Holy Spirit is here. And God is preparing a strong army in these last days. I watched as these mighty warriors stood their ground on the front lines of battle. Their faces looked fiercely as they stood firm against the relentless and ruthless attacks of the enemy. I watched in the spirit as this mighty army of arm bearers were being strategically aligned and positioned by the hand of God to bring about divine protection and divine preservation to the life of this newly appointed King of America. Then again, I saw in the spirit that these mighty ones have been carefully chosen by the hand of God would surely stand faithfully and fearlessly with President Donald Trump throughout his entire presidency, and there would be great change and transformation that would come to the nation. Now I've got a letter I want to read you. I wrote this to President Donald Trump, and I'm sending like 6 or 7 letters. If it's God's will, it'll get to him. And if you're listening, President Donald Trump, this is for you. This is a message directed to the President of the United States. Dear President Donald Trump, do you know exactly what you are doing, says the Lord? You are putting the lives of millions of Americans in danger. Have you sought my will for direction and guidance? President Donald Trump, you are making decisions on your own, says the Lord. You don't know more than me, says the Lord. My counsel is wise and all-knowing. You think you have me all figured out. My ways are not like yours. You're planning to come against North Korea. I hear the Lord say the tables will be turned on the United States of America. Humble yourself, Mr. President. America has become a haughty and prideful nation that no longer seeks my counsel. I promise Donna Bryan is here to say to you that you will seek God more now than ever before. An angel disaster is about to strike America. Prepare now for destruction, says the Lord. You have not gone to me for help, says the Lord. I am there if you will seek me in the midnight hour, says the Lord. Pride goes before a fall. Pride is what destroys people. Be not prideful, says the Lord. Acknowledge your need of me. If you remain someone that refuses to seek me, America will fall completely. Seek me now, says the Lord. I will give you wisdom and direction, says the Lord. America will need a strong and humble man to lead this nation. I, the Lord, have chosen you, President Donald Trump, for this very hour to lead the nation of America into this new millennium that is upon you. Be strong, says the Lord. I, the Lord, will fight your battles. You need only to be still. Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him and he shall direct your paths. The Lord's servant, prophet, is Don O'Brien. Father, we just pray for President Donald Trump right now, Lord. We pray for the White House, oh God. Father, you see all that's happening and what is about to happen, Lord. I ask, Father, that you would speak to President Donald Trump, that you would soften his heart, Lord, to hear your words, Lord, to know what is getting ready to take place, oh God. And I pray that the words that I've spoken, Father, will be anointed and that will get into his hands, Lord, and that for your glory, Lord. I ask you to keep us all safe, Father. You know what's getting ready to take place, Lord. Keep America safe from our enemies, Lord. Mother, keep Israel safe, Lord. We pray for protection upon Israel, Lord. We pray, oh God, keep us safe, Lord. All your people, Lord. We pray for a mighty revival in our nation, Lord. We ask you to touch people that need to come to Christ, Lord. Father, I ask you to protect those that don't know you, Lord. I pray, oh God, that they would give hearts and lives to you, Jesus. Father, before a major destruction happens, Lord, that they would call upon you, oh God, and they would be saved. If they don't know you, Lord, may they call upon you, Lord. May they call upon you, Jesus. We need you, Lord. Father, I ask for your protection. Thank you, Lord, for watching over us, Lord. We love you, Lord. What will we do without you, Lord? You are everything, Lord. We look to you. We don't look to a man, Father. We don't look to our president. We don't look to a mayor, governor, Lord. You provide everything. You provide our food, our clothing, everything. Oh, God, we look to you, Lord. We've learned to trust you, Lord. We don't trust man. We've learned to lean upon you, oh, God, for everything, Lord. You are so good to us, Lord. What will we do without you, Lord? I pray, oh, God, that you would continue to be good to your children, Lord, that love you. And that, Father, that you would get us out of here at your appointed time. Come quickly, Lord Jesus. Come and get us, Lord. Don't let us be left here, oh, God. You promised to come and get your children at the right appointed time. We pray in Jesus' name. We love you, Lord. We love you. Hallelujah. He's here right now, saints. He's here right now. Jesus is here. He loves you. He loves us. And he's here. And he will protect us. We don't need to worry. I know we're getting near something. We're getting very close to something. I know that God will keep us safe. He will keep us safe. We don't need to worry. You know, we're seeing all of this happening, and now it's becoming real. And I think that's what my spirit said to me, because it's right here, saints. It's right here. Whatever God is getting ready to do is right here. The Holy Spirit is right here, and he wants to use you. So it's so important. If you're not doing God's will, do it. Nothing matters. You hear me? Nothing matters. This world is going to pass away. Stop doing your own thing. Start doing what God is asking you to do, because we're going to all stand before the Lord. And he's going to ask us, what did you do? Don't you want God to be proud of you? I know I do. I know I'm not perfect. Lord, forgive us of our sins. Lord, wash us and cleanse us. Thank you for dying for us, Lord. What will we do without your mercy and grace that's new every day? We're thankful, Lord. Thank you for salvation, Lord. Thank you for dying and raising again, Lord. Thank you, oh God. We thank you for salvation. We thank you that we're born again, that we're not going to be left here, Lord, that you're going to get us out. We thank you, Jesus. Love you, Lord. Praise the Lord. All right, I think that's all I want to say. I want you to know God loves you. We love you. We're praying for you. Keep us in prayers. But stay close to the Lord, because things are about to change. And if you don't know Christ today, please call on Him. The prayer is up on the screen. Don't wait. Call upon Him now and be saved. I'll talk to you soon. Prophetess Donna Bryan, servant of the Lord with Dalton's Heartfelt Corner. God bless you.